going to be talking about the Selly Spader, which is an implement from Italy that's designed for primary and secondary tillage, and it's considered a conservation tillage tool because it is much easier on the soil. You don't end up with a compaction layer because of the way that it tills the soil. The way that the spader works is it's a series of these small spades or shovels that are mounted on an eccentric. So instead of spinning like a rototiller, they actually just pivot and the spade will take a bite of soil and then kick it back to this flap where it shatters. When you're setting this up, it's really important that the spader be level from side to side. And then it's also important that you have the tilt adjusted with your top link so that your gearbox, which is right here, is level when the spader is engaged with the ground. The depth can be adjusted. It has these shoes on both sides of the spader, which regulate how deep the implement goes into the soil. It's important when you're using the spader to make sure that you engage the PTO while the spader is up off of the ground. If you engage the PTO with the spader in the soil, you're going to put a lot of pressure on the equipment and you could potentially damage the spader or your tractor. This spader is sized for our tractor. So our wheels are on 72-inch centers, and that's the size of our spader because you want the spader to cover up your tire track. After the initial pass with the spader, you're going to wait a week to even 2 weeks to allow your residue to break down, and then you'll go in for a second pass for your secondary tillage. The second pass, you can lift the shoes up a little bit so that the spader is not going quite as deep, and the goal is to create a finer bed for transplanting or direct seeding into. You may have to go in for a third pass if you're doing direct seeding and you need a finer seed bed. Advantages of the spader are that it's better for your soil and that you can get in when the soil's a little bit wetter than you could if you were using traditional tillage tools such as a moldboard plow and discs or even a chisel plow and disc. Disadvantages are that it's more expensive and that it's also slower. If you figure the fastest that you can go is 1.5 miles per hour, then you're going to be taking more time to cover the same amount of distance that you would with traditional tillage tools.